Happy birthday to your pastor this morning. Let's go, y'all. Come on. Let's go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. To you. Happy birthday. Enjoy your day. Much love.
Lend me your ear for 2 Corinthians 9, 6 and 7. But I say, he that soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall also reap bountifully. Every man according as he purpose in his heart. So let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. Amen, amen, amen. So please go to bit.ly/love to give or Cash App, $ your virtual church.
Well, good morning, everybody. Hope everybody is doing all right. What's up? Thank you for those birthday wishes. Good morning. Praise be to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It is good for us to be in the service just one more time. Hope everybody is doing all right. Love you. Hey, Sister K. Hey, Sis Matt. Hey, Miss Vanessa. Hey, Shalonda. Hey, Wilma. Good morning, everybody. Hey, Miss Amy. Hey, Brother Jim. Hope everybody is doing all right. It is good for us to be here one more time. Boom. Oh, I got a word today. I got a word. Man, 55 got here quick. 55 got here quick. You know what? I love the fact. It's Sunday morning. I love Sunday morning. I don't know what it is, but I love Sunday morning. I love Sunday morning. And it doesn't hurt that today is my birthday. I was talking to Mama last night, and she said, my oldest baby. I said, yes, ma'am. I said, 55 got here mighty fast. Well, we get ready for communion. Get your communion ready. We got our wine. We got our unleavened bread. We got our cracker. We're going to have communion today before the message, and we're going to have prayer. Oh, we got a great word today. Get those notebooks ready. We got a great word today. And I know it's my birthday. I'm just going to talk a little bit. Amen. We're getting ready to get on to Sweet Bethel, and we got a word for them as well this morning. So you know the song we got to sing this morning. We just love praising the Lord. Amen. Come on, Pastor. Help me celebrate this morning. Come on. Let's go, y'all. Come on.
There's been time when I...
Let's go, y'all.
Got all in my way.
this is my song. It's prayer time, and we're getting ready for communion. Let us pray. Our Father God, we thank you again for another day of worship. We thank you for another birthday. We thank you for another opportunity to give you the praise and the glory. And Father God, thank you for things as well as they are with us. And Father God, it does seem like sometimes all we can do is just call upon your name. It's a lot going on around us. But Father God, we are going to keep our eyes on you. And Father God, we're going to lean on you. And Father God, we're going to trust that everything is in your hands. Father God, open up our hearts this morning that we may hear a word. Bless everybody under the sound of my voice. We thank you for the offering today. Continue to bless Eric Coleman. Continue to bless the Parker family, brother Jim and sister Amy. Continue to bless the Gladney family, the Butler family, the Callaway family, the Sims family. Father God, everybody represented here today, the Wilson family, Father God, the Coguts family, the Reynolds family, everybody that's represented here today. And Father God, the Coleman Walker family, bless them in my way. You know what they have on their agenda. And I just pray that you will go before them. And Father God, we love you today. We just want to tell you thank you. Everything is going to be all right. We love you. We praise you. We magnify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Still power in the blood. There's still power. There's still power.
Somebody say, it's the blood. It's the blood. If you would learn how to plead the blood over your family, if you would learn how to plead the blood over your children, you would see a transformation like never before. Somebody just say, the blood. The blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of. Come on, this is the stuff we used to do for communion. Yeah. These are the songs that carried us. It washes wine. Come on, sing it like it's Sunday morning. Say, oh, the blood. Yes, Lord.
What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Let us pray. Our Father God, we come before you right now in the humblest way that we know how. We come before you partaking of communion. You say it in your word, as often as we can, do this in remembrance of you. And Father God, we're going to examine our own hearts. And Father God, we're going to talk about it this morning. Man inspects the outside, but you inspect the heart. And Father God, we love you this morning. And Father God, let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our heart be acceptable in thy sight. Oh Lord, our strength and our redeemer. And Father God, we remember, we reflect on what you did over 2,000 years ago. You died, but you didn't stay dead. Early that Sunday morning, you got up with all power in your hand. Father God, continue creating us a clean heart. Renew the right spirit on the inside. And Father God, thank you. Thank you for your sacrifice, but you didn't stay dead. Early that Sunday morning, you got up with all power in your hand. We love you, we praise you, and we magnify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Let us all eat and drink together. Oh, praise the Lord, y'all.
There is power, power, yes it is. It's in the blood. Thank you, Jesus. Come on and sing it. Oh, power, wonder working, yeah. And somebody who's pleading the blood over your life, you know this isn't. And there is healing, yeah. It's in the blood. You can find it in the blood of Jesus.
That's come on now.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
It's in the. And just in case the devil stole it from you, there is your joy,
joy.
And it's in the blood. Yeah. Mama, thank you for telling me I can find joy. Wonder working.
Praise him this morning, everybody. Praise him this morning. What a mighty, mighty God we serve. We just want to thank everybody for your well wishes this morning. Thank everybody for being here. It is a blessing to be in the service one more time. What's up, Minister Marcus Sims? That's my baby brother, y'all. It's good to see everybody. I appreciate y'all being here. I'm not going to hold you long this morning. Oh, but I got a word. The message today is God is preparing you for your next. Oh, come on, somebody. God is preparing you for your next. Are y'all ready for this? Are y'all ready? So many times we moan and groan about where we find ourselves, and little do we know that God is preparing us for our next. Oh, come on, somebody. I know some of those things on your resume kind of make you kind of, ooh, but that was necessary. Y'all better help me right now. Yeah, somebody needs to hear this today. Somebody needs to hear this today. Look at your neighbor and say, God is preparing you for your next. In the message today, Samuel is going to go to Jesse's house. He's got 8 boys. And God told Samuel, go anoint the next king, called Saul was disobedient. And he went through all 7. You got another son, because God sent me and said the next king is here. Well, he's out amongst the sheep. David was anointed king at a younger age while he was steering tending sheep. I'm going to wait for you to shout. And I know you feel like God has promised you that, but you're not there yet. But every step along the way, God is preparing you for your next. Y'all better help me. I'm going to wait for y'all to shout. I'm going to wait for you to shout. And I just want you to shout right now. God, thank you for preparing me for my next. Somebody ought to shout with me this morning. Our scripture reading is going to be from 1 Samuel chapter 16. And what I want you to glean from the message today is that God is preparing you for your next. And I want to ask you this question. How can you be a king? Come on, Minister Melton. How can you be a king if you cannot be a shepherd first? This generation, everybody want to be president and CEO. But how many of y'all can change out the garbage bags and take the trash out? I was listening to a motivational moment with Denzel Washington. He said, "I before I started acting, I was a garbage man. I was a mailman. I enjoyed being a garbage man more." He said, "You had 3 hours worth of work, and you can stretch it to 8. In the mailroom, you had 3 hours worth of work. You had to stretch it to 8. but it taught him some things. And so many people don't want to pay their dues. They think that God can promise you this today and tomorrow is going to be here. Anointing is a process. Y'all better help me. God is getting you ready. See, if you cannot, if you can't walk with the foot soldiers, how can you run with horses? If you can't walk with the foot soldiers, come on somebody. Do y'all feel me this morning? God is preparing you with for your next. I want you to hear this. How can you be a king if you cannot be a shepherd first? Our scripture reading is in 1 Samuel 16, the entire chapter. And the Lord said unto Samuel, how long wilt thou mourn for Saul, saying, I have rejected him from reigning over Israel? Fill thine horn with oil and go. I will send thee to Jesse the Bethlehemite, for I have provided me a king among his sons. Y'all better help me. Can I chase a rabbit right now? See, being a parent, you don't know what God has in store for your children. Oh, come on, somebody. That's an extra one. That's not even in my nose. I'm just dropping that bomb on you right now. We don't understand the power of parenting. Y'all better help me. That's a whole nother message. And God told Samuel, well, Dr. Sims, why did God reject Saul? Because God told Saul to kill all the Amalekites, everything in that camp. But Saul was hard-headed, and he kept some of the booty, some of the stuff. And that's where we get the phrase, obedience is better than sacrifice, because when Saul was checked by Samuel, come on somebody, nobody want to be checked in this society. I'm going to talk about that in a minute. When Samuel checked Saul, Saul said, I kept some stuff back because I was going to offer it to the Lord as a sacrifice. Really? God doesn't need that, but God wants our obedience. Come on, somebody. You can't serve God your way. Half obedience is still disobedience. Put that in your notes. Half obedience is still disobedience. Come on, somebody. And Samuel said, how can I go? If Saul hear it, he will kill me. And the Lord said, take a heifer with thee and say, I am come to sacrifice to the Lord. Can I chase another rabbit? God don't need to tell you what he's doing. Some people talk about, well, see, the Lord, God told him to lie. No, he didn't. He just didn't reveal to him what he was doing. God can keep back what he's doing from hard-headed children. Do you tell your children everything you're doing, especially the hard-headed ones? And call Jesse to the sacrifice. Send him an email. And I will show thee what thou shalt do. And thou shalt anoint, mashach, consecrate, set apart unto me him whom I name unto thee. Mashach is the Hebrew word and for anoint, and it means to consecrate. Spread that oil over David. Cover him with that oil. Y'all don't hear me. See, in the Old Testament, that oil represented the Holy Ghost. See, I don't have to rub myself down with olive oil now because I got the Holy Ghost on the inside. Y'all better help me. And Samuel did that which the Lord spake and came to Bethlehem. And the elders of the town trembled at his coming and said, comest thou peaceably? Samuel had a reputation. He was bringing what thus saith the Lord. And do people tremble at the preacher man now? That's a whole nother sermon. Do people tremble at the prophet today? Do people tremble at the pastor today? The pastor has a bad rap today that all we're interested in is money, women, and chicken. Okay. Y'all know how y'all talk about us. But the world doesn't tremble at people of God today because we've somehow lost our voice. That's a whole nother message. And verse 5 says, and he said peaceably. Y'all come on now, wake up y'all. And he said peaceably, I am come to sacrifice unto the Lord. Sanctify yourselves and come with me to the sacrifice. And he sanctified Jesse and his sons and called them to the sacrifice. Can I say something else? Let me give you a new acronym. POOR. P-O-O-R. Passing over opportunities regularly. How many of y'all fuss at God because you believe God is not blessing you. But every time God sends an opportunity your way, you pass over it. I wish I had time to preach this morning. I know it's my birthday, but I feel God this morning. How many of us, we fuss at God. God, you ain't doing me like you're doing Vanessa. You ain't doing me like you're doing Sandra. You ain't doing me like you're doing Jay. You ain't doing me like you're doing Miss Amy. You ain't doing me like you're doing Dr. Sim. You ain't doing me like you do Kate. You ain't doing me like you do Maddie. Why? Because every time I bring something to you, you passing over it. Jesse showed up to the sacrifice. His son showed up. When God calls and when God moves, you got to move. 2/3 of God's name is go and do. There's too many lazy folks. There's too many lazy folks in the body of Christ. Faith, we said it yesterday on the show, the young man that was on my show yesterday, faith without works is dead. And a lot that we lay at God's feet and the devil's feet, what kind of choices are you making? God cannot bless inactivity. Put that in your notes. God, if you're not going to do anything, God can't bless that. Oh, I wish I had some help this morning. And it came to pass, when they would come, that he looked on Eliab and said, surely the Lord's anointing is before him, because he looked like a king. But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance, or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth, for man looketh, Ra'ah inspects. Man inspects on the outward appearance, but the Lord, Ra'ah, inspects on the heart. I wish I had some here. But the Lord looketh on the heart. See, we are so caught up on appearance. I'm going to deal with it in a moment. We are so caught up on appearance. This generation, how fake can you be? How fake can your hair be? How fake can your eyelashes be? How fake can your body parts be? How fake, and we're trying to outfake each other. Y'all, I wish I had some help. This generation of Instagram models, we paint all this stuff on our faces. We got all these filters. We got all of this makeup and get made up and got a messed up heart. Y'all better help me. What did we talk about on Mother's Day? Beauty fades. And our society, our generation, America, is all about appearance. Former President Donald Trump built an entire empire on appearance. And some say right now he is broke. Well, rich man broke. He's not a billionaire. He has lived on the image, the appearance that he's one thing, but he's something totally different. Then Jesse called Abinadab and made him pass before Samuel. And he said, neither hath the Lord chosen this. The horn of oil didn't move. It didn't flow. Then Jesse made Shammah to pass by. And he said, neither hath the Lord chosen this. Again, Jesse made 7 of his sons to pass before Samuel. And Samuel said unto Jesse, the Lord hath not chosen these. And Samuel said unto Jesse, because God said the king is in Jesse's household. Okay, so if I've seen 7, and they are not the one, logic says you got to have another son. And Samuel said unto Jesse, are here all thy children? And he said, verse 11, there remaineth yet the youngest, and behold, he keepeth the sheep. And Samuel said unto Jesse, send and fetch him, for we will not sit down till he come hither. Y'all better help me. And he sent and brought him in. Now he was rooted out of my Admonai. Admoni means red, and withal of a beautiful countenance, and goodly to look to. And the Lord said, arise, anoint him, for this is he. This is David. He didn't look like him. He was pretty now. He was handsome. He didn't look like a king. He really didn't look like a shepherd. Tell me, while you're doing what God wants you to do, won't God bless you with good looks? Won't God bless you with attractiveness? Why do you think people are attracted to us? the charisma of God, the grace of God, the anointing of God is attracted. It's not me, it's the anointing. I wish I had some. See, the anointing breaks yokes. The anointing open doors. The anointing open opportunities for you. When you are anointed, everybody else said, how did you get that? I'm just anointed. I'm just anointed. I'm just anointed. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Thank you, Pastor Sam. Thank you, First Lady Ruthie. Come on, somebody. Then Samuel took the horn of oil. Here we go. And anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. Can I chase another rabbit? What did David say in Psalms 23? He said he will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemy. Y'all better help me. Even in the midst of people hating on you, in the midst of people trying to withhold from you, in the midst of trials and tribulation, God can still bless you. I feel good this morning, y'all. I feel good this morning. But the Spirit of the Lord, in this company, in this midst. See, while one person is getting blessed, somebody else is getting depressed. Wait till I get to my lessons. But the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and an evil spirit from the Lord troubled Baal, to be terrified, troubled him. And Saul's servant said unto him, behold, now an evil spirit from God troubleth thee. See, mental health is nothing new. Saul got depressed. Because, see, you get depressed when you're out of position, when you have disobeyed God, you start feeling some kind of way when you see God blessing somebody else. Well, you had the same opportunity. God made you the first king, and you messed it up. All you had to do is obey. Put in your notes. All you got to do is obey God, what God is telling you to do. You don't have to feel some kind of way because God blessing me. Oh, I wish I had a praying church this morning. Come on, church. Let our Lord now command thy servants which are before thee to seek out a man who is a cunning player on a harp. And it shall come to pass when the evil spirit from God is upon thee that he shall play with his hand and thou shalt be well. See, the anointing amplifies your gift. I got some notes for y'all. And Saul said unto his servant, provide me now a man that can play well and bring him to me. Then answered one of the servants and said, behold, I have seen a son of Jesse, the Bethlehemite, that is cunning in plan and a mighty valiant man and a man of war and prudent in matters and a comely person, and the Lord is with him. Don't we know our gifts will make room for us? Y'all better help me. Wherefore Saul sent messages unto Jesse and said, send me David thy son, which is with the sheep. And Jesse took an ass laden with bread and a bottle of wine and a kid and sent them by David his son unto Saul. See, David went from being a shepherd to now he got a government job playing for the king. Woo! Come on, somebody. And David came to Saul and stood before him, and he loved him greatly, and he became his armor bearer. There's no more intimate position than the armor bearer for the king. And Saul sent to Jesse saying, let David, I pray thee, stand before me, for he hath found favor in my sight. See, when you do what God has called you to do, you will find favor in the sight of men. I know you're going to have some haters, but you're going to have some favor as well. Y'all put that in your note. Favor is fair. And it came to pass when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul that David took a harp. See, ain't nothing wrong with music. And played with his hand. So Saul was refreshed and was well, and the evil spirit departed from him. Praise and worship. Come on, somebody. Music soothes the savage beast. Music soothes our soul. Come on, somebody. What are some lessons from David's anointing? Number one, disobedience dismantles Saul. You want to check the messes in your life? I dare you to do a self-assessment on when you disobeyed God. God told you to go right and you went left. God told you to go straight and you turned right. God told you to go. God told you to call. God told you to write. God told you to sing. God told you to preach. God told you to do that thing and you were hard-headed. What alibi are you going to have when you stand before God and God says, why didn't you do what I asked you to do? Well, what had happened was, amen, microphone, amen, webcam. Why didn't you do what I asked you to do? Well, what had happened was, I'm going to hover here for a minute. I got 5 minutes. I'm going to hover here for a minute. We talk about what's going on in the world. What's going on with you? You might be the answer the world needs. You may be the very thing we need, and you sitting on the sideline. Everybody wants the trophy, but how many people want to go to practice? Everybody wants the ring, but how many people want to go to the weight room? Everybody want a beach body, but nobody want to do what it takes to be and have a beach body. Number one, I hope y'all highlight number one, disobedience dismantled Saul. Not the position. He was the first king of Israel. See, God chose Saul, but Saul didn't choose God. Okay. Now, number two, obedience armed Samuel. Go anoint the second king. Well, Lord, I thought you said Saul was the king. Well, no, Saul, no, I rejected Saul. Can't God do what God want to do? No, Saul was hard-headed. I don't need to tell you all that, but just go anoint the next king. Number three, being anointed has nothing to do with appearance. Can I swerve a minute? Why did Monique have to get on her social media platform and say anything to this younger generation about how they're showing up in life? Monique was going through the airport the other day and saw so many young women with bunnies on their head, walking around in pajamas, bunny slippers, wrapped themselves in rope, flying in the airport. I was getting my beard hooked up yesterday. I was talking to a grandmother that was with her grandson getting his hair cut, and we were talking, and she said, I've never seen as such. Back in the day, before we left the house, Mom said, you're not going anywhere looking like that. But pull your pants, young men, pull your pants up. Tighten your belt. Tuck your shirt in. Take that do-rag off. Because whether we want to admit it or not, this world judges you on your appearance. Because the Bible, God just said, man inspects the outside. But God inspects the heart. We are being compared to each other. How fake can we be? Are your eyelashes longer than my eyelashes? Is your wig shinier than my wig? Is your fakeness greater than my fakeness? This is a fake society. Come on, Wilma. God judges the heart of a man. I need some help. Y'all better shout with me today. But see, God, your anointing has nothing to do with how you look. Because David didn't look the part. God said, I am examining David's heart. He's right for the job. God has examined you today, and you're right for the job. Come on, somebody. Don't worry about what man says about you. There are so many. I wish I had time to stay here. We suffer so much from low self-esteem. Why? Because man judges the outside. Our self-esteem is not impacted by what God says about it, which blows my mind. When you are doing what God called you to do, your self-esteem ought to be high, but our self-esteem is low because somebody fake judging whether or not we are. You letting somebody fake judge you whether or not you real or not. And this is where I always want to holler, well, I'm just going to keep it real. Be quiet. Because you're real. Be quiet. You ain't keeping it real. You just running off at the mouth. You ain't keeping nothing real. Because this society is so surface and so fake, and you wonder why when you like somebody, it's so sad in relationships, you can't even tell somebody you like them because you don't want to appear vulnerable. And society says if you like somebody, you can't let them know you like them. We are so surface and so fake, it's not even funny. And I'm so glad God does not look on the outward appearance. God does not inspect you from the top of your head to the crown of your feet, because we ain't nothing but dust anyway. God inspects. God judges your heart. Let me keep going. Whew, Lord have mercy. Whew. Number four, a man inspects your appearance head to toe. God inspects your heart. Oh, don't wear the same outfit. As many shows I do a week, and as much as I'm on, I'm doing hours on Restream a month. I put on a different shirt. Because if I wore the same thing every show, every church service, somebody will say something about that. We inspect appearance. And that's why, that's the big argument with what Monique said. And Ricky Smiley chimed in. A lot of people kick back and push back at what Monique said. Because, but I can do what I want to do. Not really. Or I can do what I want to do. You still got milk on your breath. This society doesn't want anybody saying anything to them. Man inspects your opinion, whether you want to admit that or not. God inspects your heart. We put more, thank you, Holy Ghost, we put more emphasis on the shell, the outside, than we do our heart, which God judges. It blows my mind. We are spending billions of dollars on how we look. Do you know how expensive makeup is? Do you know how expensive a weave is? Do you know how expensive getting your nails done? I had my pedicure the other day. Miss Linda took care of me. It's expensive. Keeping up this shell is expensive. Looking well-groomed, it costs to appear. But all it costs you for God to pass your heart is to obey God. Y'all better help me. Oh, it's quiet today. Because it's where the rubber meets the road. We so fake, it ain't funny. We about as fake as a $3 bill. I got a $2 bill in the car. Your present is a building block for your next position. Come on. Your present, and so many people, and stop complaining. When you hear people complain about their present position, tell them to stop. You are lamenting, number six, God has a DPS. Now, this is Dr. Sim, you've heard me talk about this. God has a DPS. A destitutional positioning system mapped by your purpose. Every step, the steps of a good man are ordered by God. So where you are, you're right where God wants you to be. I know you may not like it, but it's your next step. Oh, come on, somebody. Oh, I feel like preaching this morning. God uses who man overlooks. They didn't think nothing about David. He's the baby son. He's a shepherd tending the sheep, something nobody else wanted to do, and he did it with a good attitude. Can I chase another rabbit? Attitude is everything. Check your attitude this morning. I got 3 minutes. Check your attitude this morning. God cannot bless a bad disposition. If you want to know something, Dr. Sim, hey, at 55 years old, I hate a complaining spirit. And I'm not talking about assessing things and really kind of mapping out things. Y'all know what I'm talking about. I hate sour pussies. I hate people that seem like they've been sucking on sour lemons and baptizing prune juice. Y'all know the person I'm talking about. God uses who man overlooked. David was hyped about being a shepherd. Come on, Wimp. Come on, Wilma. Number eight, the anointing amplifies your abilities. Humility is key. David went from a shepherd, then immediately got promoted to working for the government. He was the armor bearer of the king. David was an armor bearer. I love just going through the scripture. David was an armor bearer. See, before you can be a king, and have somebody be your armor bearer, you got to be an armor bearer because you got to understand. Come on. You can't understand what you're about to do next if you haven't done what it takes and what it has taken to get where you need to be. You feel what I'm saying? I understand what it means to be a husband and a father. I've done it. I understand what it takes to work in corporate America. I've done it. I understand failure. I've done it. I've been through some things. In 55 years, I've learned a few things. Y'all, I feel good this morning. See, that's the reason everybody can't be a coach, because you haven't lived what you're trying to coach. Come on, somebody. The anointing amplified. He said, and one of the brothers said, oh, I saw him playing that harp. That's why he's a bad man. He can play. He's a musician. David was a musician. He was a psalmist. And he played, and it soothed Saul's spirit. Y'all, I shouted. When the Lord gave me number 9, I shouted, your anointing would depress other people around you. Y'all better help me this morning. Your anointing will tick other people off. What God is doing with you is going to make folks mad. Oh, look at Dr. Sam. Oh, look at Wilma. Oh, look at Miss Vanessa. God still blessed us in a pandemic. Oh, look at Sandra. Oh, look at Kay. Look at Maddie. Oh, they all think they all that in a bag of chips. Well, it ain't me. It's God. Look at Miss Amy. Look at Brother Jim. It's not me. It's God. Oh, don't hate me. Don't hate me. You just get where God wants you to be. That's why I wrote Walk in Purpose, Grow Rich. You get where God wants you to be. God got a calling on your life. Don't hate David. You got an opportunity. You just sleeping on it. What did Jonah do? God called him to be a prolific preacher, a traveling evangelist. He want to go in the other direction. When he preached, a whole nation, a whole city got saved. God want to do great things with you, but you won't say yes. Don't get mad at me. The Lord got me this morning. I feel good this morning. You get mad at me because I said yes and you saying no to God. And you get mad at me. It ain't my fault. Me, you saying no is not my fault. And you're not going to put that on me. Your depression has nothing to do with me. Your bad attitude has nothing to do with me. And we need to stop feeling some kind of way because let me get on to y'all, the anointed. Let me get on to y'all. Quit dimming your light so other folks can feel better. Quit dumbing down your gift so that others can feel good. A lot of people in the ministry dumb down their gift so folks won't feel some kind of way. No! Jesus didn't dim his light. He didn't stop working miracles because those Pharisees had their underwear in a bunch. Jesus said, so you will know. Take up your bed and walk and get on out of here. Go on home. Only God can forgive sin. Okay? I'm tired of you dimming your light. Quit dimming your light so other folks can feel better about themselves. That's not my job. Come on, shine. The Lord said, let your light so shine. Shine your light this morning. Number 10. Come on through, y'all. Come on through. Never pass up an opportunity to allow your gift to be you. The king sent an email to Jesse and said, Jesse, we want to hire your son. Come on, somebody. Jesse, we want to hire your son. Y'all better help me. Jesse, can you get another shepherd? Because I need David. Y'all better help me. Y'all, you just tell God, the Lord, I'm here for you. Use me where you will. Oh, y'all better help me. See, David, God said, David, your throne gonna last forever. Y'all better help me. See, Jonathan, Saul's son, was next in line to be king. But God stopped that, and it shifted to David. Because the Bible said, there will come a one that's gonna sit on the throne of David. Yeah, he's the root, he's the stem of David. He's the root of Jesse. He's the stem of Jesse. And the root of David. Yes, his name is Jesus. Y'all better help me. He's a lion of the tribe of Judah. Whoo, I feel good this morning. Never pass up an opportunity to allow your gift to be used. David said, okay, I'll play. He went from a shepherd, a musician, an armor bearer for the king. What are you doing for God? Whoo, y'all. I feel good this morning. Oh, I feel good this morning. It's altar call, y'all. It's altar call. It's altar call. Come on, y'all. It's time to go to the altar. Whoo, come on. Oh, the Lord gave me this word. I couldn't wait to get here this morning, y'all. Come on. Lord, I just want to tell you thank you this morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Walk in your anointing. Let us pray. Father God, we just want to thank you today. Thank you for all your manifold blessings. And Father God, I just hope and I pray that the words will fall on good ground this morning. And Father God, let us not dim our light so others can walk in their darkness. Strengthen our hearts and our hands that we may do like David did and serve you with every ounce of our being. David is the one, the only one in the Bible that you said he is a man after my own heart. And Father God, David loved you. And may we love you like David did. And David was obedient. David, all for the most part, he always did what you asked him to do. He's anointed now. And that's how he was able to defeat Goliath. He was anointed. And if you want to defeat your giants, you got to walk in your anointing. You got to walk in that thing God has set you aside to do. Lord, we love you today. And thank you again for another birthday, Father God. Thank you for another day that I celebrate being on this thing called earth. And Father God, thank you. And bless your virtual church today. Continue to bless each and every one of us, everybody under the sound of my voice, Father God. We love you. We praise you and we magnify you. We just want to say thank you. We love you. And Father God, just help us to walk in our anointing. Help us to make a difference where we are. Father God, we love you. We praise you and we magnify you. And we just want to say thank you. We love you. And we praise you and we magnify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen again. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. God has spoken. So let the church say amen. Was that a word? Y'all, listen to our church announcer.
Lend me your ear for 2 Corinthians 9, 6 and 7. But I say, he that soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall also reap bountifully, every man according as he purpose in his heart. So let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. Amen, amen, amen. So please go to bit.ly/lovetogive or Cash App, $ your virtual church.
I just want to tell you thank you for all the well wishes today. Thank you for your attendance this morning. And I pray that something that the Lord has revealed through me blesses you in a powerful way. Walk in your anointing and you have a good attitude about it. And just say, Lord, thank you for using me, allowing me to be in your service. So let's join virtual hands. I love everybody and we're going to celebrate today. We're going to celebrate today and I love you. And thank you for being a part of your virtual church. There are two ways that you can be part of our fellowship. One, go to facebook.com/yourvirtualchurch. Hit that like button and you're part of our virtual fellowship. But if you don't have Jesus as your personal Savior, you need to accept him into your heart. Believe that he died, was buried, and he rose again. And ask him to come into your heart. Say, Lord, I'm a sinner. And I need you in my life. And the Bible says in Romans 10:13, whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. I love everybody. I love all of y'all this morning, and I appreciate you. Appreciate my gifts. Appreciate the love that you show me each and every day. And I thank God for you. I thank God for every remembrance of you today. Amen. Let's join virtual hands. Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place while you can. Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place while you can. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling, present us faultless, one day before the Father, to the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, may he rest, rule, and abide in our hearts henceforth and forever. Let every heart say amen, amen, and amen. And do these four things for me. Look in the mirror when church is open after you give. Look in the mirror and say, God loves you. Your virtual church loves you. Dr. Sims loves you. And I love you. And remember, if you stay high on life, life is going to stay high on you.